Everybody and welcome on my YouTube channel. You are with Alan Rees and today I'm on the test server to try for you what will be probably the event hero of May. It's a frontliner, an agility frontliner. It's Shadow Warrior. Where the sun moves, I must follow. This hero looks like a sort of a ninja. I pretty like his looking, and now we'll check his statistics. We will use the website hcharge.tk. I will put the link in the description of the video. And another time, if you want to know something about the game deeply, you have to know this website, who is really interesting. First point, Yukul tells us that it's a frontline agile hero who can summon, so not summon. I think they have probably the same level of English than me, a shadow to confuse enemies. The shadow serves the light and this hero has the sword medal. Not crazy interesting, but we have to know it. Now for the statistics, the website hcharge.tk. In the left side, statistics at level 109. In the right side, statistics at level 110. Because in this case, the last item of a Shadow Warrior will be at level 110. And one important point, he will be red 4 at level 107. So you can push him quickly, but after you have to wait level 110 to finish his stuff. So, statistics, HP 121,000 at level 109, 131,000 at level 110, plus 10% more or less. Armor 1,563 at level 109, 1,635 at level 110, 5% more. Not a big gap, but it's okay. Magical resistance seems to be his weaknesses, one of his weaknesses, because we have 548 score and it's the same score at level 110. So not a high score, especially for a frontliner, even if I guess that he will be behind tanks, I hope. Physical attack 12,332 at level 109 and 14,146 at level 110, 15% more, a big up this time. Armor penetration also a big up because 163 for level 109 and 203 for level 110, so 25% more. Lifesteal 80, not a huge lifesteal. Dodge score, really impressive dodge score, 230 at level 109 and 291 at level 110, so it's nearly 30% more of dodge score at level 110, and already 230 of dodge score, it's a huge amount. And finally, the last score, physical critical score, 2014 at level 109 and 2218 at level 110, 10% more. It's a good up also because we know that this amount of critical score will be something around 30, 35, 40%. So we don't have the exact value, but it will be interesting. Now we'll check his skills. I will discover the skills in the same time than you. So the ultimate skill is a Shadow Dancer. Denis summons a shadow near an enemy and the shadow shares the original Denis skills. When original Denis receives lethal damage, he can swap position and HP with a shadow. Increases Shadow Warrior's HP by 27,500. I'm curious about a lot of things. First point, the damage will be the same for the original or for the clone, I don't know. Second point, when he will swap, he will get 27,000 or he will get the more HP, I don't know. And the last point, how much time will stay the clone on the battlefield? Is it a timer or is it just 27,500 HP? We will see this during the test for sure. Green skill, Airblade. Denis throws out Spinning Blade and damages enemies. It passes Stroked, increases damage by 5,500. We will see exactly. It doesn't seem crazy strong now, but We have to see. Blue skill, fast strike. Deny strikes enemies fast and deals area damage. Increases damage by 8,800. And for this skill, I'm thinking if he has his ultimate activated, it can be a crazy, crazy big area damage. And finally, the purple skill, flare. Dennis increases his own dodge rate. Each successful dodge allows Dennis to ignore any incoming damage for a certain amount of time. Passive increase dodge rate by 110. So now I understand why the score of dodge is so high, because this passive is already counted in the calculation, and you can guess that it's 50% of the score. And finally, this skill seems really defensive and strong. We have to understand each successful dodge allows Dennis to ignore any incoming damage for a certain amount of time. I don't know if it's the next attack during a certain amount of time will be a dodge, or if it's just the next attack after the proc of the skill. So we will see this during the test, and we will try to understand this hero. First of all, his position on the battlefield. In according of the fact that it's an agility hero, and of the fact that he's a damage dealer, in according of his skills, I hope that he will be protected on the battlefield, so we will check. Okay, for the moment, behind the tank. I'm checking only with the hero that we can find at least one time in the metagame. Okay, he's in front of Dwarf Warrior, but okay, Dwarf Warrior will charge, so he will be in front of him. In front of Avenger and in front of, Divine Knight. Okay. This is stupid. He's in front of Dragon Knight and of Dragon Lord, and of Hercule. Okay. It seems to be pretty strange for me. In front of Matchless Hammer. No. Okay. I'm pretty afraid from what I see. Okay, Turtle is in front of him. Super. Now she's nearly behind all. I don't like his position on the battlefield, I will tell you the truth, because not a lot of tanks are in front of him, and in according of his magical resistance statistics, it means that if I see him in front of me, I will put some magical burst like Thunder Beast and so on in my front lane, and this hero will just explode. So we will test him now. Let's begin by the skill test, but I'm pretty skeptic about his position on the battlefield. Already a lot of answers during this skill test, you will see, especially about the ultimate. We will accelerate till the ultimate, so the green skill is not dealing crazy amount of damages. The blue skill is not bad. Okay, the ultimate will come soon. So, he's summoning a clone, and the clone is dealing exactly the same amount of damage than him with his skill. You can watch it on Admiral, 7808, and it's exactly the same amount for these two heroes, the main and the clone. Second point that we know, this clone is not disappearing by himself, he's staying on the battlefield till he will die. So he has 27,000 HP, it's not that much, but he can summon a second one. You can see that it's actually two clones on the battlefield. So you see again the damage, 7,808 by the three clones. Pretty nice. One of the clones will die soon. Up. When he die, he let a sort of tree. And the statistics, 400,000 damage in this little fight. The amount of damage is now not interesting, it's just to test the skills, but we get already some answers. So let's now do the damage test. I don't think that the result of this damage test will be crazy because Tav has prepared for us a tricky team with a cleric who will already reduce by 22% the damage of Shadow Warrior. And with a lot of stun, a lot of shield, we have also Ghost Knight who will shield. And the physical resistance of Chaplain. So we will see, but I'm not really confident about the result of this damage test. I will accelerate a little bit. Oh, we have the clone. So first, we can understand if the clone is able to survive or not. Oh la la, it's insane. He will die quickly. Okay, so it's what I was thinking when I read the skills. 27,000 of life for the clone. It's pretty ridiculous. And most of the time, he will die in some seconds. So I'm not sure that we will really get the benefit of this clone with this amount of HP. We will see, but against a setup with 5 support, we are not able to survive. So against a setup with some DPS, I don't know how they will be able to survive. But at least, if he's doing 1-2 skills, it's not bad. Okay, let's check the result. Yes, like I was thinking, 300,000, it's a bad result for a damage dealer in the damage test, but 22% reduction, lot of stun, lot of shield, so finally, perhaps that he will shine little more when we will do some real situations right now. The first test will show you one of the problems that I was speaking about during the introduction. Due to his horrible position on the battlefield, even if you use a Dwarf Warrior with him, he will be in front of Dwarf Warrior in the beginning of the charge, and he will get the debuff of Time Soldier. And finally, it's a big problem because after that, he's missing one skill and he's delayed. He do his ultimate. Look, his ultimate is instant dying. Even didn't do one skill. And we are died. So, 67,000. Even with a strong tank. I'm fighting against a crazy strong setup. I agree. But this team is in the metagame. In Arena, you can find this team easily on a lot of servers. And actually, I don't know how this Shadow Warrior can shine against this kind of setup. So let's try another situation. For this second test, at least we don't have a Time Soldier and all crazy skins of the game in front of us. So he will be able to shine better. We will see. For the moment, he's doing the job. We get some damage. We are taunted. We have the protection of Magic Breaker will help us. The first ultimate will come soon. Okay. The first ultimate is there. We are 4 against 2. Ah, 4 against 3. Shadow Reaper. And you see the bug? My clone is stuck. He's not moving. He's trying to run, but he's not running at all. So we found one bug. Okay, so second clone. Pretty funny. Okay, we killed Dub King. So Shadow Reaper is alive. Oh, she will kill. So it's a 1v1. Ultimate. Oh, he swap the purple skill and he gets some life more. Third clone. So clones are not moving. And the time is up. Pity. Time is up and we can check the result. So in this case, it was not bad at all. 490. Against us, it was a setup with a lot of damage. Potentially a lot of damage. Not a crazy Time Soldier or a Commando skin. But a good team in front of us. And in this situation, I think he's not bad at all against Shadow Reaper, because when he will die, he will swap with one of his clones. if his clones are alive for sure, and he will be able to stop the ultimate of Shadow Reaper, and it's a good point. So let's check a new situation, and I will report for sure this bug because I think that it's not normal that clones are not moving on the battlefield. Last situation, I would see if he could survive from a burst. He's not in frontline, especially because in frontline he should be died already. But in a second lane, just behind the tank, it seems that he can survive if you put with him some support. You see that I put Holy Priestess, I put Magic Breaker, and in this case, he is able to survive. So it's little better than what I was thinking, but the team in front of me is not a full burst skin, because for example, if you put Thunder Beast and Commando skin together, the result will not be the same. And also you can put Venom Master, who will add some burst, and it will be even more efficient than that. But this is a standard magical team that you can find in the metagame. So against this kind of team, there is some solution, and it's good to know. And you can see 272,000 damage. It was not ridiculous at all. I used also Time Soldier to silence a lot this team. You see that my setup, it's not a stupid setup against a magical team. I use heal, I use control of damage with Magic Breaker, and I use control of damage with a Time Soldier. In this situation, he can survive, but he's still really sensitive from magic damage. I will speak now about his strengths and weaknesses. 3 points as a strength for a Shadow Warrior. The first point, it is a capacity to mess the battlefield. If you begin to snowball with clones, it will be clones everywhere. The team will turn in all directions. And finally, you will get some benefit. And also, even if they have 27,000 HP, they will absorb 1, 2, 3 attacks in from your enemies, and it's attacks that you will not get on your team. So especially if it's area damage, it can be really nice. Second point, he's not bad as a damage dealer, especially again one time when he's summoning his ultimate, because his ultimate is dealing exactly the same damage than him with Airblade and Fast Strike, and it's pretty nice. And last point, he's crazy strong against physical setups, this hero, because his score of avoidance is insane, as a dodge score, if you remember what I told during the presentation. More than 200 of dodge score, 230 of dodge score at level 109, and it will be nearly 300 at level 110. It's pretty impressive, and the combination with his purple skill will make him totally avoid, ignore one incoming damage for a certain amount of time. It's pretty strong. Don't forget that this purple skill has internal cooldown, so it's not every time that he's dodging, he will have the effect. It's one time he will dodge, he will have the effect. The effect will be down, and after some time, you will have the effect. It's what I'm understanding when I'm reading the skill. It will be too strong in another way, but we have to understand the internal cooldown, and like usual with Yukul, we don't have this information. Let's speak now about his weaknesses. 3 points also as weaknesses for Shadow Warrior, in my opinion. The first point, the main point, it is a position on the battlefield which is just horrible. It's an agility hero. What he is doing in front of all main tanks that we have actually in the game. Matchless Hammer is behind. Dwarf Warrior is behind. Dragon Lord is behind. It's stupid. I don't understand this. And it's link for the second point. He has a low magical resistance, actually 548. And due to this position on the battlefield, if your opponent is smart, he will put in front of you Thunder Beast, Commando Skin, Avenger, Venom Master, and what else he wants, that he will burst your face, and your Shadow Warrior will die instant, and you will fight 4 against 5. So this is not possible to have this position on the battlefield. And the second point, his ultimate life, 27,500 HP, it's not enough. Because actually, in the any metagame, any setup that you will have in front of you, every time that the clone will be summoned, he will die most of the time in 2-3 seconds, and he will even not have time to deal some damages. So, finally, you will get the benefit that you will not take the damage on your face, but you will not take the benefit of damage. So, it's a pity, and I will give you now my final opinion about Shadow Warrior. Finally, after all what we saw during this video, I have decided to put 12 on 20 for this hero, little better than situational. Be careful, I'm pretty sure that it's just a first version, it's still some bugs, like you saw, and also, I don't think that you could release one hero who cost $30 and with so bad. Sorry, but there is not another word. For $30, I will never buy this hero in my opinion. You have one hero with one position who is not acceptable actually, is in front of the tanks. How one agile hero without magical resistance can be in front of tanks in the game design of one game. It's not logical and I hope that they will change. It was taking a lot of time to change this on Arcane Sapper, who has finally a better position on the battlefield and who is already better against magical damage than this hero. So, I don't know, but for me, it's a mistake. Second point, the problem of his ultimate can be solved by a little way. In my opinion, they should increase a little bit the HP of the clone, but they have to decrease the damage of the clone, because if they increase the life of the clone, for example, by 50,000, I think it could be a good amount of life for the clone. But if they are not decreasing the damage of the clone, this hero will be a crazy killing machine after the buff. So it's not the good way to do. If they want to keep the balance, they have to increase the HP of the clone and they have to decrease little bit the damage of the clone. And like that, we will have something who will be competitive, not broken as fuck, but possible to use and for sure interesting to use. So, actually, you understand that I don't advise you to buy this hero when he will be available if he's still like that. If he's changing, don't worry, I will give you the information on my channel and I will test this hero again. It's all for today. It's now time to conclude. Thank you everybody for watching this video. Don't forget to drop a like if you enjoyed it and to subscribe to my channel to not miss anything. You can also support my work by sharing this video, and if you feel yourself really generous, you can donate some bucks or join the new YouTube's program to sponsor me. Thanks again and see you soon. Bye bye.